So we are back. We are back. Welcome to the A2MG radio station. Yours truly, Philippe. You're right here with my cousin slash manager, Daryl Thomas. And we're talking about violence. We're talking about music. We're talking about good stuff, things that need to be changed, what we got to do to make a change right here on the A2MG radio station. So we are back. So continue on what you were saying. You were saying the girl got shot in front of her child.
Yes. The young lady that was, she was a TSA agent, 24 years old. She just came home from work doing her shift, had her son with her, her three-year-old son with her. Young man that was all black, hoodie on, came straight to her, shot her at the steps of her apartment, killed her in front of her son. We have these acts of violence that are happening with these guns, you know, gun violence, and is enough because these young people are not reaching their purpose in life. They're not reaching their fulfillment. They're not reaching the age of accountability. They're not reaching, you know, to be an adult. Their lives are being cut short. And I have to be honest with you, cuz it has become such a norm. I'm gonna tell you what the norm is. The norm is this: gun violence, somebody dies. Obituary t-shirts, balloon releases, and it's ongoing. Listen, I ain't got nothing against it, but it has become too commonplace. I want to get
you gotta be against something like that. You have to be against something like that for the simple fact we don't we need more role models. These guys and I would say some women, young women, are lost. It's just my opinion. And it's just an opinion. You know, opinions like assholes. You know, you either take or you don't. But it's. I don't know, man. I just know that we have to do something about that. I mean, what do we need to do? I mean, all the recreational parks are gone. We don't even have a recreational park here in Georgia. We have YMCAs here. We might have some centers that I don't know nothing about, but far as I know, we got the YMCA recreation. You know, people can join and you pay, but as far as when we were growing up, we had recreational parks where people can go and do their thing and summer programs and stuff. Well, you know, I'll take that back. I just recently just seen something around the corner saying football and cheerleading tryouts for a park over here. So I'll take that part back. But that's the first one that I've seen here in DeKalb County, you know, and I'm in DeKalb County. So, but the social media has truly taking over. The social media is a part of their clothing, their hairdo, their makeup, their high heel shoe. It's almost like you don't have an identity of your own, you know.
Well, as a matter of fact, there are more factors. Mm-hmm. I call it a pot of gumbo of nonsense that goes into that. Social media is one aspect of it. Let's talk about some of the music.
Oh, well, we could talk about, we could say it. Look at here. I heard one. Yeah. I heard a dude say in a rap, and the beat was banging. The beat was banging. But when he said that he had to go to the store and get some tampons for his girl in the rap, I said, where they do that at on a rap?
Yes. The music is the thing that moves people's souls. True. Right? Depending on what lyrics are being said in certain songs, it is like the driving force for some of this activity.
Well, yeah. And I always say it soothes the savage beast. I say it soothes the savage beast.
Let me just give you
good music. Good music.
I don't want to preach, but I'm gonna give you Bible.
Hallelujah.
Real quick, I'm gonna show you. God created Lucifer.
Yeah, he did.
When Lucifer was in heaven, Lucifer was the most beautiful angel in heaven.
Yes, he was.
But he was also the minister of music in heaven. When Lucifer fell from grace and became Satan, he still had the same attributes he had in heaven before he went to hell. Now, here's the thing about the music. We know that it doesn't matter even what song. If you hear a song with a good beat, what you gonna do? You gonna start either nodding your head or tapping your
feet? You gonna tap your feet?
That means the music has already gotten into your soul.
That's right.
Now, let's add words to it. Depending on what is said in that song, is the thing that you're gonna rely on mentally and say, you know what? I might do this.
Right.
Or I might do that.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? It's
right.
Just the basic human nature or basic human instinct. Now, when you have the social media aspect, and then you got the music aspect,
right,
and then the words behind what is being said, then all it takes is an action.
Right, right, right.
So whatever the action is, good, bad, ugly, or indifferent, that's what you're going to do.
That's true.
You see what I'm saying?
That's true.
Young people now are moved by the lyrics and the beat.
You're absolutely right.
I told somebody the other day, I said, this is just a theory with me. It's just my opinion. But I guarantee you, with all those gun violence homicides, I guarantee you, they listened to some song before they went to commit this act.
They call it the crunk song to get you ready for war. Or
exactly.
You got a point there. You got an absolute point. You got songs that get you ready to go out to the clubs. You got songs that'll get you in the mood for love. You got songs that'll get you in mood for violence. You got songs that'll get you in the mood to want to bang some heads. And then you got music that'll get you in to want to roller skate. So I do understand where you absolutely coming from, because that makes a whole lot of sense. But yeah, you ain't lying about Lucifer.
Now that's that part. Now watch this. Let's talk about economical empowerment.
Okay.
Now we know most places,
right,
inner city,
right,
they are lacking a lot of funds, a lot of diversity, a lot of programs,
right,
a lot of employment opportunities,
right,
a lot of financial ways to earn a good living,
right,
versus the suburbia, their white counterparts.
Right.
And a lot of times in the inner city, you're doing enough to just get by, or making enough to get by, or you got to get a second or a third job to feed your families. We know it's hard out there, especially for our people. Now, I understand that, you know, we always say it's either based on going sports, football, basketball, or start your own business or something to that effect, so you can really have a good lifestyle. You know, we say go to school, get a good education.
You got some of these kids don't even want to go to school no more, man.
Graduating from high school or graduating from college with a diploma or a degree does not necessarily mean that you get the job or the career that you're looking for.
Right. Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Right.
We got people that have degrees right now, can't even get a doggone job with McDonald's.
Yeah. And that's so crazy.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
So, I know it is frustrating to a lot of our people, but, you know, with us, we're resilient people. We just got to keep grinding.
Yeah.
But we got to grind the right way. We can't grind on the backs of somebody else that looks like us, talks like us.
Right.
Because that's that crab in the barrel syndrome.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? I want to see black people make it. I want to see black people thrive.
Right.
I don't want to see them just survive. I want to see them thrive.
And I'm right there with you.
Learn how to pick each other up and help each other up instead of push each other down.
Yeah. You're absolutely right. We are beautiful people. I want everybody to know we are beautiful, powerful people. When we were created wonderfully. God created us beautifully. I can't stand to see sisters still not, you know, I'm one of them type of sisters, I'm going to look out for you. If I see that, because I'm the type of person, I can go to a store. I don't care what store I go to. And if I see a sister come through, she might have an ass bigger than mine. You know, my ass is smaller than a motherfucker. I'm going to tell you right now. My ass is smaller than a motherfucker. But when she come in, if she walk through and she's nice and look decent, I'll be like, all right, good girl, you better, big booty Judy, you better work because you, shit, girl, you working. And she say, girl, thank you. I compliment my sisters. I don't care. Even the voluptuous sisters, even my with my girl, the heavyset girl that's singing now, that's doing her thing now. The heavyset girl that won an award. She did, as a matter of fact, shouts out to Rock City who wrote her stuff.
Lizzo.
I call my voluptuous women Lizzos. Because there are some pretty thickums out there with banging faces, like their faces beat to death. Nigga, they face so damn beat. I be like, I want to know who did your shit. Who did your makeup? Because I want to know who did it. And then, don't get it twisted. They be wearing their little shape-ups or whatever and everything. I'm talking about, I be like, y'all better get it. I said, the bigger the cushion, the better the motherfucker push it. That's what I be saying all the time. You hear me? But I compliment them because sometimes they might not got complimented by from anybody else. Maybe they probably was going through something and I come there at the particular, like, you all right, boo? Don't worry about it. You look good, girl. I had a good day. Claim your day. You're going to be all right. I love that look you got on, man. Even though if I couldn't wear it, I know it looked good on you. It may not look good on me, but that thing looked good. And I'll be for real about that because we need to keep uplifting our women. I mean, seriously, keep uplifting our women. Because I'm going to tell you right now, if I go to Stonecrest Mall right now, and every damn store you go through, every damn store you walk in look like you about to do a video shoot. Half-naked clothes. You got to start ordering your clothes online now. Even Rainbow's done got to the point where they started wearing half-naked shit. Like, their summer shit is nudity. Nothing full. Nudity. Like, I only got maybe two stores I can go in there right now. And I'd be like, damn, you know, I would love to wear that. But No, I can tell you right now, I walks that damn mall for about almost 2 hours till I can figure out what the fuck I'm going to find to wear for my ass. Do you hear me? And now it's to the point where all the Lizzo girls be saying the same thing too. But you know what they do? They be like, fuck it. I'm going to wear this shit and show their asses how to wear it. And don't let me tell you right now.
Because I can kind of touch on that subject, but I don't want to make nobody mad.
No, it's some girls there in Florida. Oh my God, wait a minute. Oh my God. Okay. Listen. Trick Daddy's restaurant, Sundays. Trick Daddy's restaurant, Sundays. We went to go around there because, you know, brother-in-law said, hey, I'm going to make sure y'all get through the back door. We walked. Yo, we drove the car, and when we hit the corner, we saw a long line, a snake line.
Yeah.
And not only in the front, they had a popo in the front guiding that and the traffic, and still had people in the back. Now, let me tell you what I saw in the line. Okay, we know Miami is all about it's going to stay hot, be hot, rain or whatever, the shorts and everything. I'm talking about, they talking about the Daisy Dukies and all. But baby, I seen a chick. And it wasn't right. It wasn't right. It wasn't right at all. I was mad at her. I will say, I was. She had some shorts that flared out like this. And it shaped into a heart. But her ass had dimples. Like somebody done poke holes all through her ass, and she had a nerve to be standing Aki with some green, pink, and yellow and blue ass hair and a damn Goma Pile hat in this yellow ass tube top, and her stomach was all out of proportion. And she thought she was jamming. She thought she was jamming. I like the one to get out the car and say, bitch, if you don't put on some clothes and get your life together. But you can't do that at home, because that's how they always been. That's how they dress. But dude, I wouldn't have been able to wear that. Look, I know my black ass is flabby, and I know I need to work out. But there's no way in the history of niggerdom I'm going to wear something like that, knowing that I got to get my legs together and my stomach. Get the fuck out of here, man. You made it. You just trying to say that every other female going to be like that now. It makes me mad. Now, don't get it twisted. I've seen some that wore stuff like that, and it looked decent. Bayside Mall. Bayside. Oh, my God. Bayside had females. Every female who had on, every thickum, had on a G-string and a silk see-through scarf.
Well, let me say this.
Oh, God.
I'm going to speak on this real quick.
Oh, Jesus. Father God.
We must be mindful as a people on how we are portrayed. Let me say that. We use the terms she's a queen or he's a king,
mm-hmm.
but we make it fashionable, and not understanding to be a king or a queen is about character.
You get an applause on that one. Nothing like it. Shouts out to all my black sisters out there, light skin, dark skin, in between skin, and albino skin. We are the baddest women. Right.
You have, let's say this, let me just give you two categories. You got the Michelle Obama category.
I'm the Tiffany Haddish one.
And then you got the Megan Thee Stallion category.
Ooh, nah. Wait a minute. I like Megan Thee Stallion. But I know what you're talking about as far as the look. But you got to think about it, though. Lil' Kim.
You got the Lil' Kim.
Remy Ma. And I love all of them, though. I love them all, though. You know? They brought that sex thing. But somebody told them they had to look that way, though, in order to make money.
You got, let's keep going. You got the City Girls.
Oh, and I'm, you know what?
Listen, and you got Alicia Keys.
They ain't trying to be Alicia Keys. They ain't trying to be Kumbaya. They don't want to be Kumbaya. Only time they want to be a Kumbaya with Alicia Keys when they know that they broke up with their ass. They don't want to hear that other shit. So they turn on some damn Alicia Keys, Braid My Hair, or, you know what I'm saying? Or some Mary J, you know, or some Erykah Badu, Didn't You Know? Or come on, man. They ain't trying to be no Kumbaya, my lord.
Listen. Seriously. So, I said all that to say this. Character means everything.
It does.
And character is also if you want the right man to come into your life to be that dude, that husband, whatever the case may be, it's a standard that you must portray.
That's true.
You see what I'm saying? It's a standard.
That's true.
You look back in the day. You know what was sexy to me back in the day?
What?
You know, in the 70s. You look at somebody like Tamara Dobson.
Ooh.
What's her name? Foxy Brown. What's her real name?
You talking about Pamela Greer? Pam Greer. Oh, Pam Greer was sexy mama. And Coffee?
She was sexy, but she was very intelligent.
Yes, she was. Very classy. Diane Carroll. Diane Carroll.
You look at Eartha
Kitt. Oh, I just saw her. Yeah, I just saw her last night on Boomerang. And Grace Jones was, oh my God. Yeah. Ooh, that's applause to these ladies. Rest in peace, Eartha Kitt and Diane Carroll. Rest in peace to them. Beautiful ladies. Cicely Tyson.
Rest in peace. What they went through the 60s, 70s, 80s.
Yeah.
Because it was hard for black women to break through the industry. But now, we in the new millennium, the standard is pretty much ratchetness.
Yeah.
Half naked.
Yeah.
Trying to keep up with their male counterparts, especially in the music industry.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? I personally, I'm old school. I'm like, whatever's being said in this, I don't even understand it. I don't even know what they're trying to say. But you can understand every lyric of every word of every old school R&B song.
Now, don't get it twisted. Now, there are, now, let me tell you, Murray, who's the Quicksand? Heavyset Boy to do Quicksand. I like him a lot. And he is a very humble dude. He is a God-fearing rapper. He has manners. And you know another rapper dude I admire a lot too? Roddy Ricch. I like Roddy Ricch. Oh my God, Roddy Ricch. High fashion. That Roddy Ricch is dope to me. Roddy Ricch and my homeboy, is it Murray? Murray? I don't know what his name is, but he do this song Quicksand.
Murray,
yeah. Murray. I love that. I heard his interview, dog, and I had got mad respect after listening to the interview. He's like, there's a lady who's in our age bracket. She was on the radio, and she told me, she said, let me tell you something, sweetheart. You keep doing what you're doing. You keep giving God praises, and you're going to keep shining the way you shine. Because the first thing he said, he started in the church. You feel me? The music that he's doing and everything. And I listen. I love listening to lyrics, too. That's why I'm like, I like beats. But after I hear a few things, and if that didn't make any sense, man, I'm going to cut your ass off. But when they come on, I'm all in it. All in it. Listening to Roddy Ricch and Murray. And there's another rapper that I think is pretty dope, too. Mustard, who did Ballin'. I got a new Foggy's on the Jeep. That's Mustard. There's a few of them that I like, but most of them, majority of them, all other ones, no. Mm-mm. I'm just like you, dog. I'm still Jay-Z.
The music sounds
the same. Right, I'm still Jay-Z. I'm still J. Cole. I'm still Nas. I'm still EPMD. You feel me? I'm still Outkast. I'm still Goody Mob, which shouts out to Goody Mob because they got a single album out called Survival Kit. They got like two videos out. One is for my peoples and the other one is called Frontline. And they're dope. Timo Goody, shouts out to him. He got a single out that's called The South of Sand, something with Pastor Troy. Bone Crusher. I'm the only female in that thing, too. Ain't that something? He's got everybody. Man, I have been blessed, dog. Man, damn, cuz. I have truly been blessed to be in the presence of these guys, like, especially Goody Mob, performing with them in places. Need to wipe that, please.
I will.
Now. And what's so crazy is that it is so amazing. It is so amazing. And I can't say it enough, but I'm just like you, cuz back to what we were saying. I am a total old school person too. Don't get it twisted. I give everybody love and credit. Like I said, the three people that I like, but I'm still Jay-Z. I'll be looking forward to hearing Jay-Z. There's another rapper, that's out that I like too. Russ. R-U-S-S. Check him out. Russ. He's dope. Yo, light-skinned little Albie Shore little nigga. He dope. I only say that because of the her. You know what I'm saying? But he dope. He is dope. So we're going to take a short pause for the calls right quick. This is the A2MG radio station. We're not going to take too much of your time, but we're going to do this thing right quick, and we will be right back. At the A2MG radio station, getting involved, my daughter all up in the face and putting bleach on ants and all kind of stuff. Get out of here right now. Go on somewhere, woman. I don't know why I got to be interrupted every time I'm doing something. Everybody want to be all up. If he ain't in here, why are you here? I let her go and see the Michael Jackson thing, and here she come, want to come and invade my privacy. And she done, no, this ain't not, that's not the thing to do right now. That's not it. Learning, no. Who said that? No, nah, you need music. Why don't you wait till it come out? Hard tell, woman. This is how I'm telling y'all, everything go down here on my radio station. You never know what might go on the radio station. And as you can see, I'm still a mama at the end of the day. How about that? So we are back. Let me tell you, if mama was trying to show you the goldfish and the white fish, okay, so the goldfish, I was trying to figure out which one was the male and which one was the female, and I figured it out. I said, mama, why does this fish keep sitting down in this certain area. Is he sick? He about to die? What the hell was going on with her fish? So mama said, I don't know. And then next thing you know, mama said she saw some baby fish that started coming out of the gold one. So they got three baby fish. But this is the crazy one. It's twins, and it's one white with a little orange pinch of orange on it, and then the other two came out like bronze gold, but they're twins. And me and mama was saying, okay, so did she cheat on her husband? Because he all white. I'm like, she all white, he all white, and she all gold. So why are they bronze gold? Because they don't look, they do not look orange or white. They look like this part of the keychain.
Right.
That's what they look like. And they're twins. And so I said, mama, did the man fish cheat on? Because I don't, did that, is he daddy? Mama said, girl, leave it alone. That is his father. So now the fish is sitting down again. In the same spot. And only time she come up to eat is when it's time to eat. And then she take it behind and go right back down in the spot. I said, mom, I think that damn fish about to have some more children. Because she had a big old group of fish that she grew. And that fish grew to be about this big. And every time I came over there to that house and went to that fish tank, that thing jump out and spit at you. And he was great. So I said, well, mama, what did y'all do to the fish? I think they ate it.
Big fish ate
them,
and then it died after.
Who ate?
And they cooked them.
They cooked them and ate them. It was a grouper. The damn fish.
Wait a minute.
Spit at
so,
you.
Well, I need to make sure I got this right. She had a grouper in a fish tank with goldfish.
Yeah.
So she had a saltwater fish.
And I don't know how she did it.
I think grandma knew what she was doing.
Mama's the fish guru. I don't know how she did it, but it was, if I'm not mistaken, a grouper is gray, right?
Yeah.
And were they different colors?
Okay, well, this grouper was gray with some eyes, and this motherfucker was mean and motherfucker. I think it was, I could have called it a motherfucker rooster if I wanted to. Could have crowed in that damn water if you asked me. All I know was when I used to come over there, and mama say, put a couple of drops in. I said, I'm not finna do that damn fish be coming over spitting at people. As soon as I did that, spitting at me. The hell wrong with you? Spitting at me the way you spit. I said, mama, I ain't fucking with that fish. So now when I found that fish, so they cooked him and ate him.
I saw it too.
See what I'm saying?
He ate them.
But mama only got two fish, two grown, a pair, the father and the mama. And three babies, and I think they're about to have more because she keep that goldfish is sitting down there like, oh, whoa, it's me, it's coming. You know, I don't even know if they know if they have, do they have contractions? I wonder what their contractions are like. You ever thought about that? What are fish contractions like when they have a baby? Do they do?
Yeah.
Because they're always in damn water.
Shit,
I don't know, but mama knows the kind of music mama knows be playing up in there. They be playing damn Gregory Porter and Kim. Holding on, and they're holding strong. And then Kitty has be drunk up in there, and he turned that damn U2 up so loud, and he be playing Denise Williams and everything. And I think, I don't know, they be getting, I don't know, but... Oh, you know what I just found out? Did you hear? And y'all, shouts out to, I don't know why I'm doing the laugh part because I pushed the button. But shouts out to Tiffany Haddish. Just found out that she is going to play the role of Flo-Jo.
Yeah, I heard that.
So, you know, I was listening on the radio station a couple of days ago. I'm not going to say who it was, but... I didn't like his comment about Tiffany Haddish. He said he didn't think that she would be able to play the part because she doesn't play anything serious. So people don't know Tiffany Haddish played in Madam C.J. Walker movie on Netflix and played a very serious role in Madam C.J. And I thought it was wonderful. I enjoyed it from the very beginning to the end. It had episodes, and she did a fabulous job.
Well, see, what people always say, what somebody can't do or what somebody can't see, listen, if the person does their homework, they study for the role and put forth maximum effort, that's an accomplishment for them. I mean, whoever would have thought Jamie Foxx would pull off Ray Charles?
Yo, thank you. So that's why I was trying to figure out, why would this person on the radio would say he don't think that she would be able to do it?
She getting ready to pull off Mike Tyson.
Ooh, come on, somebody.
Yeah.
And you remember the serious role he played with Will Smith and Ali as his trainer? He played the shit out of that. Yeah. He really did. Shouts out to damn Jamie Foxx, man. Jamie Foxx the shit, man. But Tiffany Haddish, to me, I really like Tiffany Haddish. People, you know, can say whatever they want to say about her, but I truly love her story. I love everything about her. I love her. I love how she's always on a impulse. She's always, you know, improv, quick. Improvisation or something like that. Did I say
improvisation?
That? Thank you very much. I knew I was saying something like that. No, I'm talking about. I knew I was saying something, but she's very good with that. I and people think she overdo it. I don't think so. I don't think she overdo it. I just found out that she's a adopted parent now. She adopted a daughter, what, 5 years old, something like that.
Yeah.
From what I was told, and she's still with Common, and I think that's kind of, now let me see
listen, let me give you a quick story on Common.
And I like Common, he cool, you know. I'm trying to figure out how they got
the story by my little brother. So everybody knows that Common is a Florida A&M graduate.
What?
With the fam, you.
What?
We're gonna repeat that.
Let me put up. Did you just say he went to Florida A&M?
Yeah, he went to Florida A&M.
What year did Common went to Florida A&M?
He went, I think when Kevin went up there, my brother, he went up there in 88, 89, 90, 91, right?
So around the year that we was in Norman and CC them, he was at Florida A&M?
Yeah.
Awkward.
Before you got out there.
So what?
They graduated in 87 and 88, and they went to fam together.
What? So don't he know? But then he know. Don't he know?
So here's a story about choices in life.
Okay.
So when my little brother went up there, he was, you know, he was a little black, and he had his little crew from Miami, whatever, right? He had just first got up there. Kevin was a little wild and whatever. Kevin, you came to the house that time when we was up there. Came to the house.
Oh, yeah.
And he always tells this story because he's very successful in his financial, he's a financial advisor up there, also insurance.
Okay.
So, he always tells the story. So, they went to a party in Tallahassee. Freshmen, they buck wild, they want to get out. And they go to this house party, and they run into some cats from Chicago. So the guys from Chicago chirping at the guys from Miami.
Wow.
So one of them was talking real reckless. So little brother, like, nigga, I'm finna do you up. You know what I'm saying? That person was Common.
What?
He always tell a story. And at that time, Kevin was also carrying a weapon.
No way.
Yeah. Because he had heard about these cats from Chicago.
Oh, Lord.
What caused Kevin not to pull that weapon was somebody with some sense grabbed him and said, nah, little black, not tonight, not
tonight. Not tonight, because he would have got got. That nigga would have got.
Listen, if that would have went down that night, my brother wouldn't be where he is.
And Common wouldn't be where he is. Whoa! So I wonder if Common remember. You think Common know? Remember that shit?
The next time I come up there, and I'm up there, and you come to Kevin's house, Kevin will tell you the full story.
I want to interview him on that. I'm going to interview him about him and the Common story. Good God!
Yeah, he'll tell you the story.
I did not know Common, because I'm going to tell you, long time ago, the first time I ever seen Common perform.
FAMU has a lot of graduates that's in the industry that came out of FAMU.
That's amazing. That is amazing.
The young man that played Bobby Brown in the New Edition story.
Yeah.
What? He's also on Power.
Wow, that is crazy.
The guy that played Johnny Gill in the New Edition story, he went to FAMU.
Wow.
That was amazing.
Hold on one second. Once again, you are listening to the A2MG radio station, and we're going to take a quick break, but we are going to be leaving in a few minutes. So in the meantime, go ahead and hear some music, and we will be right.
You say you never had it good, babe. I guess you never knew I could, babe. But if you let me into you, babe, I can work it till you do.
Girl Felipe, we're about to get on out of here saying good night at the A2MG radio station. I hope you had a wonderful time. Stay tuned. I'll probably be back on tomorrow or the next day. You never know. But I am glad that you are here to listen and check us out. Have been a fool and talk about serious stuff, fun stuff, still being a mom at the same time. You know, all of that good stuff. But I am out. Have a wonderful night. And mask or shot? I don't know. New motto. Shots or not, always stay mask up. It's your girl, Felipe. Good night.